I don't know, Dan. Figure it out.
Well, just make it happen. The recording came up and I gotta do what I gotta do. So, Dan, I won't be able to come in. Just make it happen. Just tell him whatever you have to do.
I won't be able to come to the office for a few days. Something came up and... Like I said, figure it out.
Good morning.
Hey, good morning.
Everything okay?
Oh yeah. Just work stuff. Don't even worry about it. How'd you sleep? Listen, I'm glad you're here. You hungry? Orange juice? Coffee?
No, I haven't had much of an appetite since the funeral, so.
Rach, I'm so sorry I didn't come home. I should have been there.
It's fine.
No, it's not fine. I should have been there. I'm your best friend. I should have got on the plane. I should have just
called Mike, the road don't! I'm sorry. Everything happened so fast. I mean, one minute, Derek and I are planning our wedding, and then the next, he was such a good person, a kind man. He didn't deserve what happened to him. And the way he died, I don't understand why he had to die the way he did.
Yeah, that's a horrible way to go. Being stabbed to death?
How'd you know he was stabbed to death?
Your mom told me.
You spoke to my mom?
Yeah, I did. She called me before the funeral. Told me everything that happened.
She wasn't supposed to do that.
She didn't mean any harm by it. She knew you needed me. Which makes it even worse that I wasn't there. I'm sorry.
None of that matters. You're here now.
Did they ever find out who murdered him?
No suspects, no leads, no evidence, nothing. Like, Mike, how am I supposed to grieve and move forward when the monster who murdered the love of my life is still out there? I'm scared, Mike.
I won't let anything happen to you. You're safe, Rachel. You hear me? You're safe here with me. Come on, man. That's a foul!
Hey. I'm gonna go meet with that therapist. So I'll be back in a bit.
Okay.
Thank you.